Hi, this is Reverend Ed Schneider, senior pastor and teacher of the Rock Church of Oak Ridge, Tennessee. We have a special thing to share with you today. It is a three-part series on the Rock's official first opening worship service, Christmas Eve 2010.
Good evening and welcome to the Rock's official opening service and our Christmas Eve celebration. My name is Joe King and I'll be one of the many members of the Rock who'll be helping lead you through this service this evening as we worship the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. Our worship tonight will feature familiar music and song for everyone to participate in. There will be Christmas carols for you to sing along with, more great music provided by our special guest, the Oak Ridge Youth Symphony Orchestra. Tonight we remember to honor the true meaning of Christmas. We invite you to sit back and join the Rock celebration of the birth of the church and the birth of Jesus Christ.
Again, we wish to thank these wonderful young musicians from the Oak Ridge Youth Symphony Orchestra for their efforts tonight as they add so very much to our Christmas Eve service and the Rock's official opening worship. Let us offer to God just a little more praise for their efforts and their conductor, Mr. Slade Trammell. Now, as we continue with our program, we will move forward to the call to worship. You, of course, are encouraged to join with us by responding to the sections marked as all. Let us together proclaim, sing to the Lord a new song.
Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Bless the name of the Lord.
Tell God's saving acts day after day.
Proclaim the greatness of the Lord around the world. The Lord is great and greatly to be praised.
To be held in holy awe above all other gods.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
As we now move forward with this evening's worship, let me ask you, have you ever wondered why we celebrate Christmas? I think you may be surprised by some of the answers.
How do you celebrate Christmas?
Oh, all month long.
Big dinner with lots of presents.
Presents.
Go to church.
I go into church and be with my friends and family.
We read the story from Luke, cut down a Christmas tree and decorate it. And we like to be with family and eat lots of good food.
Lots of food.
Mashed potatoes. Turkey.
Homemade tamales.
Brisket.
We still like the gifts and stuff like that for the children.
We open presents on Christmas Day, and then the next day we leave to go to Grandma's house.
With family and friends and Christmas Eve service at church.
The perfect gift.
The best gift.
Anything that involves Star Wars.
Just good health and fun times.
Season tickets to the New York Yankees.
Anything from the heart.
My kids. Kids for Christmas.
Having kids or getting to see them?
No, just getting to be with them. I don't need no more.
I want to get a Game Boy.
Concert tickets.
Money. Money.
Lots of money.
A Barbie.
A four-wheeler.
A boat.
A new truck.
A brand new Mercedes.
Some new motorcycle accessory.
World peace.
Just for the family to be together and everybody be happy.
My mom and dad getting back together.
When I had to get out of jail and quit drinking.
So why do we celebrate Christmas?
Well, probably it's about the day Jesus was born.
That you get to celebrate with your family and see everybody.
Merry Christmas, Jesus' mother, or something.
It's actually Christ's birthday is what it is.
The three kings came out to the stables to see him.
Actually, I was born and raised Jehovah's Witness, so I never got to celebrate Christmas.
I think it's time to really look at what you've gotten over the year
and what you can get for the next year.
And it is an age-old tradition, so we like to uphold that tradition.
And I'm one of the proud members of The Rock. It's truly great to see you here. My privilege tonight is to read God's holy and righteous word. I will be reading from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, the 10th through the 15th verses. The word of God reads as follows. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day, in the city of David, a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was, when the angels had gone away from them into heaven, that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." I have read to you today from the New King James Version of the Bible. May God bless the reading, the hearing, and the doing of His holy and righteous word. Let the church say amen. It is now The Rock's distinct pleasure and privilege to present you one of East Tennessee's greatest hidden jewels and truly one of God's blessed and gifted souls. Elaine Graham.
Yeah.